matchup. There he is in his eighth consecutive start. Cam Talbot, he's won four in a row, 5-1-1 since being inserted as the starter with Henrik Lundqvist out injured, and 9-5-2 overall. Across the way is the familiar Ryan Miller. Former Buffalo Sabre, went to St. Louis at the end of last season, signed with Vancouver, and their number one man with 26 wins, 6 shutouts. Marty St. Louis, a big goal the other night, 3 points in his last 2 games. Rangers are hoping he'll get on a hot streak. Rangers hoping with Derek Stepan centering St. Louis and Kreider, McDonough and Girardi on defense. And an offside quickly.
This Vancouver team is really beat up. They've got 4 defensemen that are out of the lineup hurt. We just saw Weber. He was a healthy scratch for 3 consecutive games before being put in the lineup last game. So they got some youngsters.
A quick chance and a save by Talbot. The puck bounced lively off the boards, and Daniel Sedin had a great chance. Talbot ready for it. Here he covers up and stops play.
Boy, what a save. What a save. Right off the faceoff, the shoot-in. And it was out of the reach. And you saw Daniel Sedin just skate right in past everyone. No one picked him up. And what a chance. He is a good shooter of the puck, and Talbot makes an excellent first save.
You saw the lineups come in at the top of your screen moments ago. The starting lineups are brought to you by Infiniti, luxury cars that deliver inspired performance. Here's Alex Biega, number 55 on defense, just called up for their last game on Monday night. And he scored a goal in his first NHL game. He's 26 years old, a graduate of Harvard University. He played his first NHL game the other night after playing over 300 games in the American League.
Yeah, he's from Montreal, and he went to Harvard because of Ted Donato.
That's a good reason.
He had a relationship with the family and decided to go there. Spent 4 years at Harvard.
And works out in the offseason with our Harvard man.
Right, Dominic Moore.
Here's JT Miller centering to Boyle, and Hayes firing toward the net that was blocked in front. Puck around to Carl Hagelin. Hayes, Hagelin, and Miller, the line on the ice here. Adam Clendenning checking Hayes, number 44, Clendenning. There's Hayes coming back in, sending it deep. Ryan Stanton, number 18, bumped along the boards. Rangers putting early pressure on the Vancouver defense. Hayes across to John Moore. Moore in the lineup tonight is Alain Vigneault alternates that 6th defenseman. Shot by Moore goes wide. Matt Hunwick is a healthy scratch.
And Sam, that was the key phrase, pressure on the Vancouver defense. That's what the Rangers want to do, get in there. Again, they're missing many of their regulars. And so the Rangers want to put some pressure on them.
And pass out deflected, popped in the air, is played by Yannick Weber. Weber sends it in. McDonough and Girardi back after the puck. Dominic Moore is on with Tanner Glass and Lee Stempniak. McDonough pinning one of the forwards against the boards. That was Bo Horvat, the man he was checking. Here's Dan Hamhuis playing it up to Yannick Hansen. Hansen passed through to Weber. And Weber sends it ahead. It's fired in. Stahl and Klein on defense. The puck on goal is gloved by Talbot, and he holds it.
Well, after that initial real good save by Talbot, the Rangers were able to get down the other end and do some good work on the boards. Miller, Hagelin. Here's the play by Hayes. Tries to get to the front, but it hits the skate of Miller as Hagelin was wide open on the other side of the net.
Second meeting of the season between these two teams. Rangers beat the Canucks 5-1 in Vancouver in the start of a road trip to Western Canada in the middle of December. Stahl back for the bouncing puck. One-time Ranger Christopher Higgins from Smithtown, Long Island is on the ice, number 20. Higgins, a first-round draft pick of Montreal. Rangers got him in a trade. Racing down to step on after the puck. Biega with a good hit on him. Puck up the boards. Higgins chips it out of the zone. Recovered by Marty St. Louis. Pass deflected across. McDonough left it behind. And is picked up by Henrik Sedin. Pass through. Trying to get it to his brother Daniel.
Girardi with a good job with the stick on Daniel.
Rangers have won four in a row. 7-1-1 in their last nine. Second place in the Metropolitan Division. The Islanders on top. The Rangers have three games in hand. The Islanders are home tonight against Nashville. Nice lead to Derek Brassard. Controlling. Brassard tried to pass in front for Nash, but it was broken up.
Boy, he had Nash wide open in front.
McMillan dropping it off for Hamhuis, who fired it into the corner. Haglin leaves it. Dan Boyle with the outlet to Brassard. And the open man is Haglin. It's off his stick. He tipped it ahead. Haglin checked by Hamhuis, who's able to move it to McMillan. And McMillan comes out, feeding it to former Ranger Derek Dorsett, who's on number 51. Dorsett skating very, very well. And according to Willie Desjardins, his head coach, has been a very pleasant surprise as far as his overall play.
Well, he knew him because Dorsett played for him in junior hockey, so they had a relationship before then, and Dorsett has gotten good minutes playing for Vancouver.
Yeah. Hayes moves in, slides it on goal. It's stopped by Ryan Miller. That's missed by JT Miller, no relation. Miller waits and leaves it for Clendenning. Little over 5 minutes gone by in the first. Rangers with one shot on goal. A Hayes shot that Miller handled easily. Clendenning holding, and his pass was deflected, taken by Stempniak. Stempniak moves it and shoots it blocked. Good pressure here for the Rangers' fourth line. And the puck brought in by Higgins, who shoots wide. On the boards. Higgins has a five-game point-scoring streak, but all assists. Long pass broken up by Biega. Stall against Verbata. Verbata's the leading goal scorer for Vancouver. Signed as a free agent and is a dangerous man. Good goal scorer. Biega holding. Off the glass, all the way down. Played by McDonough. With the outlet to Chris Kreider. Kreider moves in against Weber. Pass across and a shot. Save. Rebound saved by Miller. As he stopped Ryan McDonough, who moved in for the rebound chance. Rangers' best chances early in the game. There's no score.
John Giannone back at the Garden, where during the commercial break they have honored Alain Vigneault, who 5 days ago in Arizona achieved the accomplishment of 500 career wins, one of just 21 coaches to reach that plateau, the fourth fewest games to get there, and of course 313 of those wins, guys, was behind the bench of the team the Rangers are facing tonight, the Vancouver Canucks.
And there he is on the list all time, tied with the late Pat Burns, who was voted into the Hall of Fame. And Alain Vigneault in some outstanding company as he moves up the rankings.
He's a heck of a coach. Now every team he plays for, the players play for him. You know, not everybody loves him because that's the life of a coach, right? You're not going to get everybody to love you. But they, you know, every team that he's coached for, they respect him. They go out and they play hard. They feel comfortable enough to go out and he wants them to make plays. And that's the way he coaches, and that's one of the reasons why he's had so much success.
He's a winner. There's no doubt about that. And he has learned. He started very young in his career in Montreal, and he had one outstanding season. Had some difficulties. Was relieved of his job. Went to Vancouver and had great success there. And now having an excellent success in his first two seasons with the Rangers. And his pass of Boyle tried to keep it in. It went just outside the line. Canucks take over. 7:15 gone by. First period. Scoreless game. Dan Boyle hustling back after the puck. Sean Mathias there, number 27. And Derek Dorsett, number 51. Kreider, quick outlet to Stepan. Stepan to St. Louis. And the sharp angle shot stopped by Miller. The net gets knocked off the pegs and play stops. Good rush up the ice. Good breakout by the Rangers.
Well, the Rangers have been doing that. Again, they Vancouver wants to prevent those types of rushes. But here's McDonough leading the rush. Good outlet pass. Kreider, rebound. Guess who's there? McDonough. He starts it in his own zone with that wonderful skating ability and passing ability, then followed it up exactly like the coach wants. Follow up the play if you're a defenseman. Put himself in a position and force Miller to make an outstanding save.
Rangers move in. Hayes feeds Hagelin. Hagelin around the net. Picked up there by Horvat. Klein to Stahl. Stahl's wrister blocked in front. Diego with the block. Hansen lifts it out of the zone. That's blocked with a body by Hagelin. Kevin Klein. That's tipped in by Hagelin. A bouncer that goes by Ryan Miller. And Alex Biega picks it up, fires out. Hansen couldn't handle it. It's back in the Vancouver zone. Lucas Spezza sending it all the way down. This turns into an icing on Vancouver. 8:09 gone by here in the first.
Now the head coach of the Vancouver Canucks is Willie Desjardins, and that's partly what he's dealing with. Alexander Edler out. Nick Bonino out. You know, that's a pretty good list of guys that have been really important to his team. And he still has them in a playoff spot.
Three starting defensemen and a couple of starting centermen.
Right. You know, and it was interesting to hear him tell us before the game, Sam, about this group of defensemen that's now in the lineup. He said, with this group, said we should be able to move the puck a little bit quicker and a little bit better. It's a different style that they've got in there now than of those players that are injured. But he has them, you know what, he has them playing hard. They've had a good season. They've won a lot of big games. No one really expected them to be a force in the West this year.
Got off to a good start. I would say over the last month and a half to 2 months, Joe, they've been a 500 team. They've won some, they lose some. They win three in a row, they lose two. But they got off to a real good start this season, and that's kind of put them, set them up for this run toward the playoffs. They're in third place in the Pacific Division and in a playoff position. Icing again on Vancouver.
And this is the first of a five-game road trip for them. They'll play the Devils tomorrow, the Islanders in a couple more days, and they'll go up to Boston and face a Boston team that's lost five in a row right now. Boston's on that road trip where they have to play Chicago and St. Louis before they come home, and they're being threatened as far as the playoff spot, and then they'll finish in Buffalo for game number five on this trip.
Buffalo? Did you say Buffalo?
I did say Buffalo.
Tomorrow in Buffalo.
How can I not be thinking of Buffalo?
Tomorrow in Buffalo, it might be a high of 5 degrees. Fired in. That's deflected by Stanton. Up into the netting and play stops. 8:40 gone by. Several stops and starts the last couple of minutes. Tonight, right here on MSG Plus, Henrik Lundqvist hangs out with Chef Mario Batali. And together, they design the perfect mask to be auctioned off for charity. Catch the series premiere of The Mask with Henrik Lundqvist, presented by Visa, tonight after post-game coverage right here on MSG Plus.
Well, it's nice to see Henrik Lundqvist on the ice. Not taking any shots, but he's out there with his goaltender equipment on. That is a good sign.
That was a positive sign. And Mario Batali will be Al Trotwig's guest after the first period. Daniel Sedin sending it deep, went wide of the net. Daniel Sedin is number 22, Henrik's number 33.
And Burrows is back on that line with those two, and it's been a good line.
Henrik Sedin, he's the setup man, the passer. That's knocked away. Good play by Mark Stahl. Loose puck in front. Burrows with a pass. Nice job by Klein checking Daniel Sedin.
And Nash coming back. Well, I tell you what, you have to have players back around the net when they have the puck. Just as soon as you think you've got control of the puck and it's going out of the zone, they make a play.
The lead to McMillan, who fires it low around the boards, but offside whistle on the play. You mentioned Henrik Lundqvist. And this morning on the Garden Ice before a few of the extra players came out for a skate, there was Henrik Lundqvist in full equipment, but not taking any shots. No shots, no pucks, but in equipment, moving, exercising. Certainly a positive sign.
Yeah, he is quite the person. Not just the player, quite the person. a leader on this team, has helped Cam Talbot deal with what he's got to deal with. And then just everything he does for the city of New York and you name it, charitable work. He does it all.
Off the boards and out of the zone. Race for the puck, McMillan and Dan Boyle. Boyle gets there. Boyle finds an open, just missed, connecting with Lee Stempniak. No score in the game. Past the midway point, first period. Here's Bo Horvat moving in. Pass across, tipped by John Moore. Cleared out by Stempniak. All the way down it goes and it becomes an icing on the Rangers. 9:40 to go. Shots are only four apiece.
Now the game started off with Vancouver getting that real good early chance by Daniel Sedin on the dump it. And then the Rangers had a couple of shifts that they put pressure on Miller. But it's also, we've also seen a lot of icings, a lot of whistles for offsides. If you're the Vancouver Canucks, boy, you want to come in here and try and take the crowd out of it, slow it down a little bit. Play a conservative road game.
There's Henrik Sedin, checked there by Dominic Moore. Daniel leaves it for Henrik. Henrik picked up again by Moore. Good job by Dominic Moore. Alex Burrows winds it for Henrik Sedin. Daniel takes over. Good one-on-one coverage by the Rangers. That shot by Clendenning was blocked in front. John Moore kicks it up to Stempniak. It's picked up and brought out by Dominic Moore. He leads Haglin. Haglin with Clendenning on him. Clendenning roughing up Haglin. Clendenning lost his stick. The play continues on. Dave Jackson and Ghislain Hébert are the referees for tonight's game. Girardi's pass blocked by Lyndon Vay. Vay number 7. Rabada number 17. There's a block in front by McDonough on the shot by Hamhuis. Around for Kreider. And Kreider breaks out. Pass a little behind St. Louis. Moves in with Stepan. St. Louis drops it back. Save made by Miller on the shot by Girardi. Pass in front. Score!
What passing! This play is unstoppable. The first one was Marty St. Louis here to Girardi. Miller the save. And then this, Girardi, St. Louis, Stepan in. That quick. And the Rangers take the lead. You don't see better passing than that. That puck never stayed on the stick of Girardi or St. Louis or Stepan. Bang, 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 and it's in the net. What a goal.
Goals in back-to-back games for Derek Stepan. He now has 6 points in the last three games, including this one. 2 goals and 4 assists. And Marty St. Louis with 4 points in the last three games. So some good signs for the Rangers. At 11:39, Derek Stepan gets his 11th. He's averaging, since he came back from his injury, averaging just under a point a game.
Yeah. You know, and Marty St. Louis, you talk about him, who went through that streak of 15 games without scoring a goal, and he had had a conversation with John Giannone last week when we were on the road, and he talked about the, you know, the difficulties of having that kind of streak and off you stay with it and fight through it and all that. Well, he has. He's starting to go again now.
The puck deflects off the glass, played by Rick Nash, who turns and shoots. Saved by Miller. Alex Biega fires it up the boards. All the way down it goes. And it's an icing on the Vancouver Canucks. Stepan got his 11th from St. Louis and Girardi at 11:39.
And again, lots of icings in this first period. And a lot of that, part of that certainly is because of the Rangers trying to put pressure on those defense.
Rangers, one of the best teams in the NHL when they score first. 27-5-2 when they score first coming into play tonight. Eric Dorsett chips it off the boards. Klein comes over and clears it out. And JT Miller moves in. Clendenning is there behind the back feet. Shot by Stahl. A save by Miller. Great pass from Miller to Stahl. Ryan Miller coming up with a save for Vancouver. JT Miller winds it to Hayes. Devin Hayes checked there. Chipped off the boards, but blocked by Mark Stahl. Here's Hayes. And the puck moved by Clendenning. Dorsett able to clear it out. Ronalds Kennens was stopped. Offside was whistled against Vancouver. 7:09 to go in the first. The goal by Derek Stepan, a beauty, giving the Rangers the lead. Moments I like. Now it's time for the Coors Banquet Timeless Moment. Rod Gilbert becomes the first and only Ranger to register 1,000 career points with the Blue Shirts. February 19th, 1977.
Not a bad player, number seven.
What a great ambassador for hockey. That guy loves to play this game. He loves hockey. Talked about how much his dad loves the game. Puck around the boards. Mark Stahl tied up in the corner by Bo Horvat and Hansen. Puck fired off the glass by Dominic Moore, and Karam's out of play. 6:51 to go in this first period. Tomorrow night on MSG2, the Rangers are in Buffalo, the makeup game. The Rangers and the Sabres live coverage begins at 6:30 with Visa Rangers game night, and then it's the Rangers and the Sabres on MSG2. Check MSG.com to find out the channel locations in your area. Clendenning had to go off his stick and he plays in cross. The Canucks, with all the injuries that they've had on defense that Joe was mentioning earlier, called up the one-time Ranger first-round draft pick, Bobby Sanguinetti. He is not in the lineup, but he was in uniform for the pregame warm-ups. He played in the KHL last year and was signed as a free agent by the Canucks. There's a lead for Nash. It was tipped by Ham Hughes.
Boy, that's a good play by Ham Hughes. He just got a piece of it, or Nash would have had a breakaway.
Bouncing puck in front. Higgins plays it back. And a giveaway to Brassard. Is it shot wide by Zuccarello? Nash. And Girardi. There's Rick Nash. 12 points in his last 9 games, including 7 goals. He's second in the league in goals scored. Alex Ovechkin, 37. Rick Nash, 35. Pass for Nash, who is tied up by Weber in front.
Vancouver has gone now 11 and a half minutes without getting a shot on goal.
Wow. Off the board, stopped by McDonough. Up ahead, Kreider leading San Luis. Back for it, Henrik Sedin. Daniels got it. Now Henrik. Spisa's pass to Alex Burrows. Burrows moves it on Klein, who blocks the shot. Good job by Kevin Klein. Daniel Sedin now to Alex Biega. Biega had it deflect in front. Bouncing puck was missed as Daniel Sedin tried to get a shot off. Henrik to Daniel and back. Henrik with the puck. And Klein on him. Shoved him down. Strong play by Kevin Klein. Henrik Sedin, shot deflected away by Stepan.
Well, these guys are so dangerous, aren't they? You get everybody back to try and defend, and they still find ways to be dangerous.
Rangers did a good job of coverage. Spisa playing it ahead. Tipped by Kennens to Hansen. Hansen pass taken away by Boyle. He fires it out. 4.5 minutes to go, first period. Rangers a 1-0 lead. I'm on Long Island. The Islanders have a 2-0 lead on the Nashville Predators. Shot by Horvat, a save by Talbot. There's the first shot in, what, Joe, 13 minutes?
About 13.
Hayes with a nice lead. Haglund cuts up. Shot by Boyle, saved by Miller. Big shot in stride. Horvat. Kennan's able to clear it out. And that looked like Boyle was taken down. Rather, John Moore was taken down. He gets up and shoves back on Hansen. And looks like Hansen will be the only one going. Rangers have a power play coming up.
Rangers have the 1-0 lead. They've outshot Vancouver 9-5. Now they'll get the first power play as Yannick Hansen, watch him here first. Their skates come together, he and John Moore. No penalty there, and then at the end of it, Hansen gets his stick into the skates of John Moore, and John Moore didn't like that. Hansen gets the only penalty, and the Rangers with the first power play.
John Moore okay. Upset to say the least. This Rangers power play is presented by Volkswagen. Rangers did not get a power play opportunity in the game against the Arizona Coyotes, had two against the Islanders, so they're 0 for 2 in their last two games. Nash, Stepan, Brassard, Saint-Louis, excuse me, that's Zuccarello and McDonough on for the Rangers. McDonough carrying. Rangers are 10th in the league on the power play. Nash fires across off the boards for Zuccarello. Chipped it ahead. Brassard back up to Stepan. Now Brassard. There's Stepan to McDonough. Back the other way to Brassard. Derek Dorsett, one of the penalty killers with Alex Burrows for Vancouver. Rangers kept to the outside. Now Nash down low. Back to Brassard. Looking. Nash for Zuccarello. Chipped it on goal, but didn't get a whole lot on it. And Miller able to make the save.
Again, excellent puck movement by the Rangers. Finding the open man. Good movement on this power play. They just keep working it around, trying to get Vancouver out of position. They do there, and Zuccarello got part of it. Good job, actually, by Burrows, number 14 in white, to come back and get part of that shot.
Rangers send on Hayes, Kreider, Saint-Louis, shot by Girardi, a save. The rebound covered up by Miller. Girardi and Boyle are the point men on the second power play unit.
Another alert play by Marty Saint-Louis. He got in there quickly, right off the faceoff. Marty Saint-Louis will get into the corner. There he goes, gets in. Now the hard pass, quick shot by Girardi. Right on net, rebound, and Miller able to cover up.
Good play. Hayes against Henrik Sedin. Rangers control. Girardi to Boyle. Boyle with room. Big shot. Saved by Miller with a glove, and he holds it.
Well, they lost the faceoff and retrieved the puck on the previous one. This time they win the faceoff and they're able to get another pretty good scoring chance as Dan Boyle walked in from the right side. Ryan Miller signed a 3-year, $18 million contract in the offseason after he was traded from Buffalo to St. Louis at the deadline a year ago.
Saint Louis for Hayes off his stick and chipped off the boards and out of the zone. Girardi lost it to Brandon McMillan, who moves deep. Good play by Boyle to stop him. 30 seconds to go. Rangers power play.
McMillan was just picked up off the waiver wire from Arizona.
Round the boards. Hayes double team. Camus couldn't clear. Girardi off the stick of Kreider. Kreider sends it around the boards for Hayes. Hayes out to Dan Boyle. Now Girardi to Boyle. Back to Girardi. He's got room. Hayes with a redirection that was blocked by Ryan Stanton. Cleared to the line, out of the zone. And that will do it for the power play. Rangers had three shots on goal on the power play and have had eight of the last nine shots on goal in the game.
Well, that was real good puck movement by both power play units.
Tanner Glass. Dominic Moore after it. He bumps there with Alex Piega there. The former Harvard grads going at one another. Shot by Stahl, blocked by Higgins. Chris Higgins plays it out to Verbotten, gets it back. Talbot. Nice outlet pass to Lee Stempniak. Brought in by Moore. Moore takes it deep and shoots. Saved by Ryan Miller, and he holds it with a minute 18 to go in his first period. The Rangers have taken over control of the game. Tomorrow night on MSG, catch J.B. Smoove along with guest Godfrey, Gus Johnson, Lisa Lampanelli, and David Krumholtz on an all-new episode of Four Courses with J.B. Smoove. That's tomorrow night at 11 after the Knicks on MSG, presented by Cadillac. Grillo on, Rangers 13 shots on goal. Canucks 5, Rangers with a 1-0 lead on the goal by Derek Stepan. Matthews moves it. Henrik Sedin after it. Picked up by Burrows. Taken away by McDonough. Zuccarello carries out. Miller got a piece of it. Played back by Yannick Weber. Under a minute to go in the first period. Nash gets some room. Pass to Brassard. Now to McDonough. Save made. And the puck went up into the netting.
Boy, the Rangers have just taken over this period. And they had momentum on their power play. They carried it forward to here. And Vancouver is having a difficult time in their zone trying to contain this high-scoring Ranger team. And they are finding the open man. Talk about playing unselfish. You see what Ryan McDonagh has done lately, coming off that spectacular game against the Islanders.
And four goals in six in his last six games.
And he's had a couple of really good chances here in the first period. Yeah.
Rangers' puck movement has been outstanding in the second half of this period. Maybe more than that. Hayes tried to center his block. Hayes again, controlling, battle in front. The pass goes through and out of the zone. And Mark Stahl cuts across to get it. Yannick Hansen on him. Back the other way, Lucas Spisa picks it up. Now Clendenning onto the stick of Derek Dorsett. Yannick Hansen moves in. His feed for Lyndon Bay missed. Rangers take over. Final seconds of the period. Cheers are starting to build from the crowd. Solid first period for the Rangers. Vancouver got an early chance. Talbot made a big save, and after that, Rangers took charge of the game. Stepan got the goal to give them the lead.
Well, they dominated, and I think if you're Vancouver, you thank Ryan Miller for having a really good first period. But Elaine Vigneault's team, they came out with energy. They came out with speed, this defense for Vancouver. And again, there you see the shots, and Ryan Miller in goal was very good.
Vancouver had only one shot on goal over the last 17 minutes plus in that first period. Diego able to get it to Sedin. We saw Sedin pass goes all the way down, turns into an icing.
I was going to say, Sam, we saw plenty of that too in the first period. The number of icings that Vancouver took, because when they got the puck, they look up, there's a Ranger right on top of them. They don't have time to find the open man, so they're trying to make, you know, they're trying to make the conservative play and go up the boards as opposed to trying to go through the middle without looking. And so a lot of those plays up the boards turn into icings.
Stepan Kreider, St. Louis. McDonough and Girardi on for the Rangers to start the second period. Kreider had a shot blocked by Viega. Chris Higgins plays it back. Alex Burrows. As it goes, Girardi stops, leaves it there for Stepan. Rangers move it quickly, short passes, get out of the zone. Stepan one hands it ahead. Andrews has trouble with it. That's kept in by Girardi. Higgins able to fire it out for Burrows. The play by McDonough in the neutral zone. There's Girardi lifting it out. Rangers defensively very solid.
Well, Vancouver's not getting up the ice with the puck. As soon as they look up, look at the pressure. Somebody from behind, somebody in front. Now they've got to get rid of it. And the Rangers end up with control, at least momentarily.
Kennedy stopped there. Teed up by Hansen, plays it to Ryan Stanton. That was deflected by McDonough and taken away by McDonough. Sarge pass intercepted by Spisa. Rangers get it back. It's cleared out to Yannick Hansen. Hansen checked there by McDonough. Talbot got a piece of it. Here's a chance. Score! Sean Matthias just coming off the bench. And Mathias has tied it. The Rangers guilty of making a mistake. McDonough upset on the play.
Well, he and Hansen came together, and McDonough actually made a good play on Hansen. Hansen ended up with the puck just inside the blue line. McDonough played him. Here it is. Takes him in. Does a pretty good job. Hansen stays with it, though, and that puck goes off the side of the net and then deflects to the high slot. No one picked up Mathias coming off the bench. And Hansen wouldn't give up on the play. You'll see him knock it right off. Oh, pardon me, went off the stick. Went off the stick of Talbot and not the side of the net. And Mathias found it, was patient, and put it in.
So Mathias gets his 14th at 1:43, and the Canucks have tied the game. It's a big goal for Vancouver. Outlet to Ryan, to JT Miller. He's checked by Ryan Stanton. Stall with Mathias on him. And Viega takes over. Sean Mathias was part of the big trade between Florida and Vancouver, in which Roberto Luongo went to the Florida Panthers. Mathias with 6 goals in his last 7 games. He had a hat trick against the Boston Bruins. That puck coming all the way down. Ryan Miller out to get it. Mathias from Hansen at 1:43 ties the game. Lyndon Vaes passes to Radim Vrbata. It's a move on John Moore, who stayed with him. Stempniak for Tanner Glass. Tanner Glass spent time with the Vancouver Canucks, part of a couple of seasons. Glendening gives it away. Stempniak to the net, and he was stopped by Miller. He made a lot of moves. Miller was able to stop him. Made another save on that last shot.
Miller's been solid. Rangers could easily have had a couple more goals in that first period, but Ryan Miller's stellar play has kept the game close until Vancouver tied it here in the second.
That was a huge save. 3.5 minutes gone by in the second. Dan Boyle for Mark Stahl. Here's Burrows dropping it off. Shot by Henrik Sedin. A save made by Talbot, and he holds it.
Well, the Rangers came back, and Dominic Moore quickly on the forecheck gets in. Glendening has it, gives it away. That's one of the few times that they tried to go up the middle with it. Stempniak read it, and Miller with that save. Here's the giveaway again. Stempniak has had more of an offensive presence in the last few games.
Stepan wins the faceoff. Kevin Klein moves it. San Luis was bumped by Yannick Hansen, and the puck cleared out by Stahl. Kreider, it'll work it ahead. San Luis to Stepan. Got the shot off, but it went wide. Kevin Klein blocks the clearing attempt. San Luis bumped Weber, who went down. And Hughes bumped along the boards by Stepan. Canucks clearing attempt blocked by San Luis. Rangers try to turn it. Step on for San Luis. Rangers recover in center. Klein fires it around the boards. Zuccarello. Shot toward the net. Saved by Miller on the long shot by Ryan McDonough.
Dan, we'll take another look at this goal, and it'll illustrate the work. Let's watch the bench. Now he stopped it right here. Here's Mathias right here coming off the ice. Now what happens was it looked like McDonough had control of the puck, so the Rangers now go to a defensive mode. They spread out, but Hansen stayed with it. He ended up batting the puck off the side of the net. It goes to the slot where there were no Rangers there, and Mathias took advantage and tied the game.
Nash controlling, sets up McDonough, kick save, went off the referee, and is played by Stanton. Brandon McMillan able to clear it out. Nash plays it across. Here comes McDonough right back in. Challenges Spezza. A pass in front was broken up by Stanton. Girardi has it back. Sent in by Nash. Played by Ryan Stanton. And Derek Dorsett. Haglund got a piece of it. Mathias sends it into the Rangers zone. 5:20 gone by in the second. Canucks have scored to tie the game. Haglund. Now Miller's shot saved by Ryan Miller. GT again is stopped by Ryan Miller. Shot by Boyle, saved by Miller. Oh, three big shots, and Ryan Miller comes up with saves. JT Miller had a real good second chance. John Moore with a check along the boards. Kevin Hayes takes over. Fires it deep. Haglund goes to get it. Haglund bumped by Verbata. Up the boards. Girardi gets there to keep it in. Verbata able to move it out of the zone. And Henrik Sedin dumps it in. Girardi hit by Sedin, able to play it around. Stopped by Cam Hughes, who fires across, just missed by Burrows. Burrows was open. Trying to bat it in out of midair. Brought back in by Henrik Sedin. Now Burrows with a shot, saved by Talbot. Canucks with a lot more offensive life here in the second period.
Yeah, well, really, this is the only line that's really been dangerous from the opening faceoff for Vancouver. Anytime they've had offensive zone pressure, it's been this line with the Twins.
Girardi lifts it ahead. Stanton stops it and holds on to it. Now Clendenning for Horvat. Checked by McDonough. Talbot got a piece of it. McDonough with a good job on Horvat.
That's where Horvat scores his goal. 5 feet out from the net.
Stanton for Horvat. Got it to Kennens. Kennens around the net. Pass in front off the stick of Hansen. Yannick Hansen circling. Now Stanton. Shot blocked by Tanner Glass. And brought out by Dominic Moore. 7.5 minutes gone by in the second. Game tied 1-1. Clendenning's pass all the way through. Played by Kevin Kline. Icing whistled against the Canucks.
Now, Sam, we saw the player coming off the bench, Mathias. But then you see this look here, and the skates come together. The feet come together. Talbot, watch the bottom of the screen. And Girardi, right there as Talbot's trying to move over.
Oh, yeah.
Girardi takes the feet out from under him, accidentally, of course, and that prevented Talbot from pushing off and coming across and taking care of that short side.
Rangers control again. Boyle deep. Pass San Luis to Stepan. He's checked by Mathias. And Sean Mathias able to move the puck. Blocked by Boyle along the boards. San Luis is there. Boyle trying to move it ahead. Boyle taken down by Mathias. And Stanton able to lift it out. Clendenning lost it. San Luis winds it deep. Rangers are out shooting the Canucks 21-9. But the game tied 1-1. That puck all the way down around the boards. Line ridden to the boards by McMillan, who fires in front. Stahl got a piece of it. Verbata shot it wide. And Stahl, under pressure, Klein helps out. Nash lifts it ahead, knocked down by Viega. Viega fell down. Rangers take it back. Brassard. Now Alex Viega tied up. Zuccarello's pass up the board. Stahl pokes it ahead. Brassard fires for Zuccarello. That was tipped. Zuccarello, nice pass. Stahl winds it deep for Rick Nash. Checked by Lucas Spezza. Stahl to Klein. Brassard checked by Lyndon Bay, who's able to move it. And it's sent in by Viega. Off the boards, Klein for Zuccarello. Try to lead Hayes. Hamus sends it the other way. Burrows across to Weber. Weber's pass was tipped. Comes to Henrik Sedin offside Vancouver. 10:33 to go. Second period. Vancouver Canucks get a goal from Sean Mathias that tied the game at 1. The young hockey players were on the ice here at Madison Square Garden as the New York Rangers are hosting the fourth annual Hockey Weekend in New York through Sunday, February 22nd. Fans are invited to attend special events across the tri-state area. Meet Rangers alumni, win exclusive prizes. For more information, visit NewYorkRangers.com/HWNY. Hockey Weekend in New York. Brian Mullen was here today. Adam Graves was here today. Glenn Anderson here today to skate with the kids.
Yeah,
on the ice.
This is going to be going on all over the place. Dave Maloney, of course, will be involved, as he always is.
Yeah, for sure. They've got lots of former Rangers who'll be handling clinics, including Mark Jansons, Glenn Anderson, Jill Villemur, Brian Mullen, Chris Katsopoulos, Steve Valiquette, Dave Maloney, Tom Laidlaw, Ron Greschner, and Pete Stemkowski.
Pretty good group.
Yes, sir. What a great weekend, part of Hockey Weekend in New York. Burrows with a takeaway and a shot, deflected up in the air, batted down and a save by Talbot.
Daniel Sedin with that one. Or was it Daniel? No, pardon me, Henrik.
St. Louis winds it deep. Vancouver much better here in the second period.
Yeah, they certainly have more life. They arrived in New York a couple of days ago. They came in a day early. The Rangers totally controlled the play in the first period, and the Canucks have had a little bit more jump here in the second.
Icing was whistled on the play, 9:27 to go here in the second.
Now they put more pressure on the Rangers in their own zone in this period. Here's the turnover. Burrows with the shot, and there's the hand-eye coordination of one of the Twins.
Henrik.
I'm just testing you.
I always go with H is the higher letter. He's got the higher number. D is the lower number. He's got...
That's too much thinking. That's too much thinking for me.
That's the only way I can put it together.
Henrik had two of the five shots for Vancouver in that first period.
They are identical twins. They play identically. Viega. Knocked down. Broussard to Nash. He breaks to the net. He scores! Rick Nash with his 36th goal of the season gives the Rangers the lead.
I'm telling you, this pass from Broussard is brilliant. This was not a clear lane for the pass. You'll see Broussard put this through a player right there. Right onto the stick of Nash. I mean, that was an absolutely brilliant, brilliant pass. And then Nash just does what he does best and scores the goal. That was Viega, 55, who tried to get in position. And the quick turnover by the Rangers in the neutral zone, quickly the other way. Excellent pass and the finish by Nash. And good for him, that's 36. Ovechkin got number 38 tonight.
That's right, Ovechkin continues to go. He scored again, so it's Ovechkin 38, Nash 36, turning into a two-horse race. Here's Hagelin. He fires and it's blocked. Ryan Stanton went down on one knee to block that shot right in front of Carl Hagelin.
Rangers goal is the 36th of the season.
The puck forced out of the zone, so the Rangers lead for the second time of the game. Rick Nash with eight goals.
16, Derek Broussard.
And
number 17,
let's check the number of games. Eight goals in the last 10 games, including this one.
Now, for goaltenders, they watch Rick Nash. They don't know if he's going to deke, take it to his backhand, take the quick shot. He's got them totally confused.
Rabada leaves it for Lyndon Bay. And Derek Broussard comes up with an assist now in five straight games. Nash from Broussard and John Moore at 11 minutes. The puck all the way down is an icing on the Rangers. 7:39 to go in the second. Rick Nash. Oh! He's high-sticking John.
John, home. Come on, stay up by the boards. Quit hiding back there.
That was a delayed penalty, so they just let the penalty.
Boy, have you gotten the hang of that down there, haven't you? You just kind of smoothly move back there.
Don't let the visuals fool you. I don't have it smoothly at all.
Burrows takes it away. Henrik Sedin's got it. Shot by Viega. Stick save by Talbot. Up into the netting it goes. 7:27 left in the second period. Rick Nash with another goal. That's 36. The leading goal scorers in the National Hockey League, Alex Ovechkin, who has won tonight in the game in Washington against Winnipeg, has 38. Rick Nash scoring one tonight, second with 36. Joe Pavelski of San Jose and Steven Stamkos of Tampa Bay with 31 apiece. Stamkos scoring last night in Tampa Bay's win over Anaheim. Quite a scoring race. What a season Rick Nash is having. Came into the game ninth in the league in scoring overall. Knocked away from St. Louis by Spisa, then cleared out by Girardi. And it's whistled down for an icing. Let's check out our Cadillac trivia question for the night. Cam Talbot making his eighth consecutive start. Who was the last Rangers goalie besides Henrik Lundqvist to start eight straight games?
I think you have to go back.
Yeah?
Just a few, I think.
Yeah?
I think.
Okay.
He hasn't missed many games in the last 10 years,
no.
Has he?
No. Oh, well, not. No. That's for sure as far as Lundqvist is concerned since he took over. You're right about that. Played by Derek Stepan. Shot by McDonough. Ryan Miller got a piece of it. And it's cleared out, picked up by Kennens. Two on one. Kennens moving in with Bo Horvat, who scores! Oh, good pass, good finish by Horvat. And the Canucks answer right back and have tied the game.
Now, Ryan McDonough has been really, really good at pinching in and forcing the play. And he'll pinch in there. Puck gets past him. Rangers don't have a forward back to take his spot. Two on one. And Horvat, as we talked about, he's a 19-year-old rookie. And this is where he scores most of his goals. He was telling us this morning, he said, you know, I came to camp. I wanted to make sure they knew I could play defense. He's an excellent man on the faceoffs. And since they got his trust, they started giving him more opportunities, more ice time, and he has been scoring as of late.
Well, you talked about it in the pregame show, and Coach Willie Desjardins told us before the game that the Horvat kid has earned everything that he's gotten.
Sam,
no gimmies to a first-round draft pick.
He's 19, and he's like a man. He doesn't have to grow up and grow muscles anymore. I mean, he is filled out. He's a strong kid. They use him an awful lot to win key faceoffs.
So Nash scored at 11 minutes to give the Rangers the lead. 2 minutes 18 seconds later, Horvat ties it. Daniel Sedin's pass was broken up. Rangers come out. Nash with Savard. Nash moving in. The trailer is Kevin Klein. He gave it back to Nash.
Now he got defended right away. He had to make a quick decision. And now, now Zuccarello's involved. And they exchanged slashes.
Penalties are coming up to both players. They're coming up before this.
It's the end. They're holding the skates down. They don't want anyone to get kicked with the skates. And Zuccarello, I think I've told you I have a love affair with Zuccarello, haven't I? He doesn't care. I mean, this is Burroughs. There's a little bit of history as well, because remember it was Burroughs that hit McDonough last year and injured his shoulder right at the end of the season last year. So there's a little bit of that. Burroughs plays that type of game where he's an irritating player to play against. And so then this happens. But Zuccarello doesn't care who it is.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, there's a couple of wood chops.
The Canucks number 14, Alexander Burroughs. The Rangers number 36, Matt Zuccarello.
There they go, right in front of the...
Yeah, that started, that was the last. There were a couple of high sticks by each player prior to that.
Let's go to ice level. John Ginone, what do you hear?
Yeah, Joe, you mentioned that Alex Burrows has a history with the Rangers. It's also sort of the way he plays. He's been going at it all night with Chris Kreider. They've pretty much been on the ice the entire time, and they have had five or six incidents like that behind the play. The Ranger bench knew it. Matt Zuccarello knew it. And when his opportunity came to stand up for his teammates, as you said, Joe, smallest guy, but he stands as tall as anybody else.
Yeah, he sure does. He doesn't care. And Burrows has always had this and played this style of game where he irritates players. He'll do some things that irritate the other team. And this is a kid that thanks Elaine Vigneault for giving him a career. It was Vigneault that talked to Canucks management into bringing Burrows up when he played in Winnipeg, which is an American Hockey League team at the time. And it was Elaine Vigneault that got him his start, and he's made the best of it.
No loss of manpower on the ice. Team skating five aside. Stepan with a shot that was stopped by Ryan Miller. Good shot by Stepan as it was set up after the faceoff. Ham Hughes fires ahead. Mathias double teamed. Rangers take it away. And it's cleared out by St. Louis. Burrows and Zuccarello get 2 minutes each for high sticking and slashing. So each getting 4 minutes at 14 minutes. McMillan's pass off the stick of Mathias. Girardi comes away with the puck. Mathias tied him up. Girardi recovers. And out of the zone it goes. 5:10 to go, second period. And the game tied 2-2. Rangers have led twice in the game. 1-0 and 2-1. Talbot for Dan Boyle. Haglund clears it out. Good pressure there by Hayes, forced a turnover. JT Miller's got it. Now Boyle across, stepping up. John Moore saved by Miller.
That was all set up. Hayes kicked the puck over to the other side to Miller, and Rangers nearly scored off that play.
Verbata's pass given away to John Moore, moves in, and another save by Miller. John Moore getting a couple of real good chances. Lucas Pisa, pass intended for Higgins, picked up by Lyndon Vay. Vay winds it deep for Higgins. Off the glass. Hayes forced back by Derek Dorsett. Taken away by Henrik Sedin. Hayes gets it back to Boyle. And the puck goes past Ryan Stanton. Goes back to get it. Under 4 minutes to go in the second. Daniel Sedin for Henrik. Back to Daniel. Deep for Derek Dorsett. Dorsett checked by Staal. Boyle moves it up the boards. Knocked down and moved by Boyle to Tanner Glass. It was Stepniak who knocked it down. Stepniak after it. Icing whistled against the Rangers. 3:34 to go here in the second.
Well, Burrows and Zuccarello. Guess where it starts, folks? How about right here? Defensive zone. They're already having conversations. They've already bumped into each other. Zuccarello, another bump. Now he gets taken down by Burrows. And it just continues. 4 minutes each is fair.
Got a little nasty there with the stick work.
Dan Boyle, by the way, has been on the ice a long time. Has to stay out there because of the icing.
Carried around the net, Yannick Hansen. Boyle trying to stay with him, does. Hansen's got it again and shoots. Glove save by Talbot, and he holds it. 3:22 to go in the second period. Vancouver Canucks keep coming back. Bo Horvat finishing it off to tie it at 2. Here are the Metropolitan Division standings brought to you by Kia. Islanders first place. They're playing tonight, leading in the second period over Nashville, 3-1. Rangers second place, 3 games in hand on the Islanders. Pittsburgh playing tonight. They're at 73 points. Washington, a wild card team. In the other division, Boston is a wild card team, with Tampa Bay, Montreal, and Detroit, the top 3 teams in the Atlantic Division.
Florida's been getting closer and closer, and they're playing in Montreal. No score in the second.
Shot by Spezza, deflects wide. Picked up by Tanner Glass. Glass carries across, drops it off for Stempniak. Taken down by Kennings, who takes the puck away and a whistle.
It should have been a trip.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, it is. Okay. Because that was a skate to the leg. And the right call. You'll see Stempniak, after he takes a drop pass from Tanner Glass, he tries to make a little movement. Watch his skates. Kennings is a hard-nosed Latvian player that just sticks out his leg. It's his ninth game for Vancouver. He played in the Olympics for Latvia for Ted Nolan, who was the head coach. We'll see him tomorrow night. Head coach of Buffalo, he coached that Latvian team.
Rangers' second power play of the game. This power play presented by Volkswagen. Kennings for tripping at 16:55. Rangers had three shots on goal on their first power play. The lead for Daniel Sedin. He rode McDonough into the boards. McDonough, St. Louis, Stepan, Brassard, and Nash. Zuccarello, who normally would be on the power play, is in the penalty box. Stepan plays the boards all the way around for Nash. Fires toward the net, blocked in front. Pops in the air. Brassard trying to gain control. It's out of the zone. 2:20 to go. Second period. Game tied 2-2. Stepan, good pass to Nash. Moves, turns, got shoved by Ham Hughes, and the puck out of the zone, recovered by McDonough. St. Louis touch pass to Stepan. Lead for Kreider across to Brassard. Rangers changing some players. St. Louis fired it on goal. It was blocked, and it's cleared by Yannick Hansen. 45 seconds to go on the power play. Dan Boyle is on. JT Miller is on. Girardi, Kreider, and Hayes. Around the glass. Hayes hustles to it. Checked there by Weber. Played back to the board, to the blue line, to Dan Boyle. Behind the back to Hayes. Miller cutting toward the net. Girardi with a shot. Saved by Miller. JT Miller gets it back from Kreider. Set up for Boyle, who's in his skates. And it's cleared out to Chris Higgins. Higgins carries it in, controls. And it was missed by Boyle. A save on Horvat by Talbot. Power play is over. One shot on goal for the Rangers on that power play. Under a minute to go in the second. Kennings. And that was deflected off the glass. It goes. Horvat recovers. 2-2 the score. And this is an icing on the Canucks with 46.5 remaining. Dorsett not pleased with that call. Experience blue shirt action in a suite at Madison Square Garden this season. A limited number of single night suites are now available. Visit NewYorkRangers.com/suites or call 212-465-6771 to reserve yours today. Dominic Moore with Stempniak and Glass. Stepniak's got it. Dorsett on him. Diego's pass, and Canucks try to come out. Rangers almost took it away. Run in by Dorsett. Here's Ham Hughes in deep. Checked there by Klein. Stempniak to Moore, and Moore was hit by Dorsett, who takes it back. 20 seconds to go in the second period. Rangers led 1-0 out of the first. Vancouver tied it early in the second. Rangers regained the lead at 11 minutes. Rick Nash with a puck here. Shooting deflected off the glass and goes. And then the Canucks tied it a little over 2 minutes later. And the horn sounds, ending the second period. Much better second period for Vancouver. The Rangers have let the lead slip away twice in the game.
Well, Vancouver just looked like they had more energy in that second period. They had more jump to their game. They put more pressure on the Rangers in their own zone, and that created more scoring chances for you. They'll have plenty of chances in this third.
Kreider and Burrows having words. There you go. There's a good view of that.
Well, they've had an ongoing battle as well, not just him and Zuccarello.
Burrows with a couple of cross checks at Kreider. Kreider answers back. They drop the gloves. Kreider looks to be a little too strong for Burrows.
He is for most players.
So that, you saw it coming as they lined up.
Well, Burrows actually was the first one to drop his gloves. You'll see him off the faceoff. He gives Kreider two cross checks. And then Kreider, this is the way it starts. One, two there. And then Kreider gives him one back. And then Burrows will be the first one right there to drop his gloves. Kreider is so strong. Not known to be a fighter, hasn't done much of that in his career, but he seems to be learning. And Burrows is...
Well, neither man shied away, that was for sure. And they will sit for the next 5 minutes. And word from downstairs, there may be an extra two to Burrows.
Well, Burrows again was the
he's upset.
He was the first one to drop his gloves.
You can see how upset Burrows is, but the Rangers are going to get a power play out of this. Their third power play of the game. And McMillan goes across to serve the extra two. So the Rangers wind up with a power play. And the Rangers have Naz, Brassard, and Zuccarello with McDonough and Stepan. Meanwhile, Higgins was stopped by McDonough, but they have it back. Horvat to Higgins. And the extra 2 minutes called cross-checking on Alex Burrows. 2 for cross-checking, 5 for fighting. Kreider, 5 for fighting at 7 seconds. Let's see if the Rangers can take advantage. Step on to McDonough. Through to Zuccarello. Down low Nash. He fires. Saved by Miller. McDonough. The step on. Out to McDonough. Now Zuccarello to Nash. Broussard at the side of the crease. Step on. Stops it with a skate. Fires. Zuccarello shoots. Blocked. Clearing attempt kept in. Stepan's got it. Stepan, nice pass through to McDonough. Cross, Zuccarello to Broussard to Nash. And it was blocked.
It almost deflected in. It hit the skate of Zbiza. And just trickled wide of the far post.
What a pass, Talbot to Broussard. But the Canucks come over to stop Broussard. And the puck cleared out by Mathias. 35 seconds to go on the power play. Dan Boyle on now with St. Louis. JT Miller, Girardi, and Hayes. Here's Kevin Hayes. Trying to break through. Yannick Weber put it in the corner. Ryan Stanton for Vancouver, number 18. And that's a penalty on Hayes. He got the stick out. And the Canucks maintain possession. Hayes all over Hansen. Around the boards for Daniel Sedin. And they get an extra man out of the penalty box as McMillan on the delayed penalty. The goalie has gone to the bench. Extra man on for Vancouver. This is Daniel Sedin holding. Henrik Sedin now drops it back to Daniel. He drops it back to Henrik, who brings it across. Met by Girardi off the skate. Daniel Sedin blocked by Stahl, sliding across. And finally, the whistle blows, stopping play. And the Canucks will get a power play on a hooking call to Kevin Hayes.
Now, by controlling the puck for that amount of time, it allowed the other penalty to expire. There's the trip or the hook, whichever way they call it, on Hayes. And so the Vancouver Canucks will have a full 2 minutes on their power play.
Their first power play of the game, 2:39. The time of the penalty to Kevin Hayes. Rangers are 10th in the league in penalty killing.
And the power play has been an issue for Vancouver.
Yes, it has. They have not scored in the last five games, 0 for 7. They haven't gotten many chances. They haven't scored when they have chances. Here's Daniel Sedin. Rangers have Haglund and Dominic Moore with McDonough and Klein. Verbata sending it back to Clendenning. Now Henrik Sedin's pass tipped into the corner. Radim Verbata. Daniel Sedin, who was knocked away. Good play by McDonough and a clear by Haglund.
16 of the last 19 games that Vancouver has played, they have not scored a power play goal.
Adam Clendenning, Boston University product. Here's Verbata moving in on Staal, shot it wide. Stopped by Daniel Sedin. Henrik back to Daniel. In front, save by Talbot on Hansen. Big save by Cam Talbot. Hansen again, save by Talbot. Pass in front, deflected wide of the net. Verbata, big time pressure by Vancouver. Henrik Sedin, now Daniel. Holding, back pass to Clendenning for the shot, they score! Talbot was screened in front. And the Canucks, with a power play goal, have the lead for the first time. It's 3-2.
Boy, Talbot had made some quality saves prior to that. And Vancouver just stayed with it. They were able to get to the loose pucks to keep the pressure on. Daniel Sedin ends up with it here. He'll eventually just go back to the point. Clendenning, an offensive-minded player. I think that was tipped. Let's see. I thought Henrik got it. He put his stick there. Here it is again. Henrik get a piece of it. I thought he did. He did.
Yeah.
He definitely got a piece of it. So Henrik Sedin scores the goal on the deflection.
So now the Rangers... we'll have to find a way to come back here. The Canucks started slowly. And they've tipped the scales in their favor here early in the third period. Nash sending it out. Rangers failed to capitalize on their power plays in the game. Three of them. And Vancouver has come through on their first chance. Here's Dan Boyle. Down low, trying to get it to Nash. Good play by Spisa. Cleared out by Brandon McMillan. Spisa has it back. Into the Rangers zone. Boyle back for it. Horvat on him. On the boards, Kennens is there. Now Haglund. Excuse me. Haglund pushes it ahead. Weber playing it deep. That was blocked by Boyle. Cleared out by Haglund to step on. For St. Louis, who moves in and shoots, scores! What a play by Marty St. Louis! Taking it off the boards and scoring to tie it at 3.
The initial shot from Weber was blocked by Dan Boyle. Right there. And then this hard pass, it's a good pass. But then St. Louis, you see him jump so that the puck would go off the boards and be in front of him when he regained his stride. And then throwing it into an area and getting the shot all at once. Boy, oh boy, what a play. Tosses it to an area where he can then shoot it quickly. Puts it underneath the stick of Hamhuis. And then the quick release. When he gets hot, he gets hot. And he's been on a streak the last few.
Marty St. Louis with points in 3 straight games and goals in 2 in a row. And the Rangers get the crowd alive with the goal by Marty St. Louis. Step on with the assist. Henrik Sedin had given Vancouver the lead at 3:55. And the Rangers score!
Deflected it. This was a bad turnover by Vancouver. Rangers got in quickly. You'll see a backhand pass from Henrik Sedin. He don't see him do that very often. And then that wrist shot by Girardi deflected by Haglund. So the Rangers strike quickly with two goals and regain the lead.
Two goals in 21 seconds turned things around.
John Gianone's report from the coach to get in and put pressure on. They did.
Here comes Hayes. And Miller covers up. Oh, the Rangers all of a sudden have raised their game by three levels.
How about the noise in Madison Square Garden? Listen to it.
Sedin had given Vancouver the lead at 3:55. San Luis, a minute 8 seconds later, tied it at 5:03. And 21 seconds after that, it was Hagelin at 5:24.
Standing ovation by the Ranger fans on the quick response by their team.
In a minute 29 seconds, three goals were scored.
You know, Sam, we really shouldn't overlook the pass that Stepan made to Marty St. Louis. He had to put it where he did.
But what a play by St. Louis to have the foresight to jump over, jump up, let the puck go through and take it full stride.
If he tried to stop it with his skates, he would have slowed down, right, and that would have negated the scoring chance.
Rangers take it away. John Moore gets it to Stepan. A couple of Rangers bumped at the line, St. Louis and Kreider. But the Rangers remained onside. Kreider checked there. He's back from his five-minute fighting major, which happened at 7 seconds. Alex Burrow is still sitting out an extra two. Kevin Klein recovers the puck. So the Rangers fell behind briefly, and now have regained the lead. It's 4-3. Off the boards for Kennens. Horvat taken to the boards by Broussard. He busts loose. Pass back to Hamhuis. Deflects in front. Blocked. And the Rangers clear it out. Kreider looking. Taken away by Yannick Weber. Weber moves in. Stahl gets over to get a piece of it. It almost went in. Talbot trying to keep it out. Where's the puck?
They're trying to look under Stahl, and Stahl is trying to make sure it didn't go in. Stahl made a beautiful play to deflect it, and then what a scramble to try and keep it out. I'm sure they'll take another look at this. What an effort by Talbot after he misplayed the first one. And then got back over and Stahl. Look at that.
Fans are cheering.
What an effort.
The effort by Talbot and Stahl.
And it didn't look like it went in. Stahl was laying across the goal line. Here, look at this effort first to keep it out by Talbot. What a play. And then Stahl lays across the goal line.
There it is, and Talbot gets the glove and pulls it back. I believe at that point, Talbot has the puck in the blocker glove. At no point can I see the puck going across the line, Joe.
You saw Kennens tried to jam everybody in to the net. 41 is Kennens. There's the puck. He kicks it once. There, it's still there, and you lose sight of it there. It looked like Talbot was reaching out with his hand to grab it. It might have still been underneath Stahl as Kennens is saying it's in. I think Stahl ended up with it.
Stahl.
Did he?
Stahl said, maybe. I don't have it. All right, it's Ghislain Hébert, the referee, is on the headset. Chris Kreider taking a look across. There's 13:08 remaining in the third period.
And then when did the whistle blow? And did the whistle, was there an intention? Where's the puck? And seeing Talbot.
He's got the puck in his glove. Talbot's got the puck. That puck never went in. Unless a second puck appeared out of thin air.
Stahl handed it to him. But it looked like he ended up, because he reached with his blocker hand once. after Kennan's just kept jabbing away at it. He tried to push Stahl and everybody else and anything else that was in the way into the net. But at the end, you saw Talbot open the catching glove and hand the puck to the referee.
Willie Desjardins, Vancouver's head coach, looking. There's Stahl lying across the goal line. Talbot reached back with the blocker glove. At that point, I thought he had it. And
he might have just then slid it to his catching glove, which is Hamhuis's right skate is right near his catching glove. There it is. I don't think it went in.
And that's the thing, Joey.
You know?
We always talk about the situation looking for the puck going across the line. At no point there do you see the puck across the line.
Not once. Not once from any of those replays, for sure. I think Talbot ended up grabbing it. Then there was, I think, kind of a pileup, so he probably wasn't sure and eventually felt it and pulled it into his catching glove.
All right, here comes the official announcement.
After review, there's no conclusive evidence that the puck crosses the line. All night is
going
to stand. No more.
Okay. So.
What an effort, though. I mean, that whole sequence. The Rangers gave the puck up in the neutral zone. Kreider was trying to make, he had some open men. He was trying to find a way to get the puck in. And Weber really made a good defensive play, stepping up on Kreider. And that Stahl with the block of the Weber shot. Cam Talbot with the extra effort to keep the puck out of the net. Stahl with the dive with the extra effort to keep the puck out of the net. Players flying all over the place.
So it remains 4-3, Rangers leading it.
This has turned into a good hockey game. You know, I mean, the Rangers were dominant in the first period. It looked like they were going to run away with this game. And Vancouver says, no, we got more to our game than what we showed in the first.
Higgins playing into Verbata and into the Rangers zone. Stahl's pass taken away by Verbata. Saved by Talbot. Another bad giveaway. And Talbot coming up with another big save. Verbata behind the net. Poked into the corner. Nash able to take it away from Lyndon Bay. Gets it out to Zuccarello. To recap the scoring in this period. Henrik Sedin from Clendenning at 3:55. And Vancouver took a 3-2 lead. And St. Louis from Stepan and Haglund at 5:03 tied it. Here's Derek Dorsett. That deflects on goal and Talbot makes a save. 12 minutes to go in the third period. Marty St. Louis tied the game at 3. 21 seconds later, Carl Haglund gave the Rangers the lead.
The mask, and they sell it.
Yep.
And all the money goes to charity. A wonderful thing.
I loved Al's interview with Mario Batali after the first period.
What's he doing wearing shorts?
I was hungry.
Huh?
I wanted some of his sauces.
Sammy was wearing shorts.
He obviously is in the wrong city. Spisa up the boards, out of the zone. 11:35 to go. Third period, Rangers with a 4-3 lead. Islanders lead Nashville 5-2 in the third period in their game on Long Island. Boyle battling McMillan through Dorsett centering. Sean Mathias, who has a goal in the game. Clendenning playing it deep for Dorsett. Dorsett checked here by Dominic Moore. Wraparound try, saved by Talbot. Batted down. Scramble is on. The puck's loose. Dominic Moore's got it. Man, there have been some dangerous moments around the crease.
Vancouver is going hard to the net in this game. And they are attacking the net, trying to get there and throwing pucks that way.
A hit on Tanner Glass by Ryan Stanton. That centered, saved by Miller on the shot by Lee Stempniak. 10:49 to go on the third.
Boy, and then just prior to that, good pressure. Derek Dorsett, here he is, 51. That one gets deflected. Good job by Talbot. And then Talbot makes one more.
Wow.
Right pad save on the rebound. There, Dorsett with a couple of chances.
Scramble in the circle. Moved ahead by Brassard to Nash. Nash against Hamhuis. Nash's pass was blocked. And the Canucks come out. Kennens leading Yannick Hansen. Kennens picks it up. Goes deep. Checked there by Klein. Hansen to Hamhuis for a drive off the glove of Talbot. Big shot by Dan Hamhuis. Yannick Weber. Despite being down three defensemen in their lineup due to injury, Canucks have hung tough. There's Hansen toward the net, saved by Talbot. Time for the Papa John's third goal replay, Joe.
Well, you know what? We're going to show the third goal, and then we might as well just kind of move right into the fourth goal that gave the Rangers the lead. Here it is. Beautiful pass to St. Louis. So acrobatic. Jumping over the puck and then making the move to make it a 3-3 game. And then that play, turnover by Henrik Sedin. Perfect shot pass by Dan Girardi, redirected by Carl Hagelin, and the Rangers lead it.
The day after the Rangers score three or more goals, get 50% off your regular menu priced online order at PapaJohns.com with promo code Rangers3. Available at participating Papa John's locations. Well, since we gave them the third goal replay and the fourth goal replay, we get extra pizza.
Let's see, 50 plus 50 is 100, so it should be three pizzas.
Hayes, pass taken away by Verbata. 9:40 to go in the third.
I don't think I'd be one of their better employees.
No, we want to be a customer. We want to eat the pizza. That was taken on a hop by Talbot. Stops play. 9:34 to go in the third. Rangers leading. Carl Hagelin had the fourth goal. Let's answer the Cadillac trivia question for tonight. Cam Talbot making his eighth consecutive start. Who was the last Rangers goalie besides Henrik Lundqvist to start eight straight games?
I'm going to go with Gilles Villemur.
Gilles Villemur?
Yeah.
I'm going with Kevin Weeks. And it's Mike Dunham. Mike Dunham in 2000. Gilles Villemur. waving the white flag. Gilles is involved, by the way, in this whole hockey
right.
Weekend in New York.
I'm giving him some
one
love.
One of the great people. St. Louis. Nicely to Kreider. Kreider moves in and was stopped by Biega. Good play.
Yeah, real nice recovery. He turned and skated toward his own net to pick up some speed before turning backwards again and making the defensive play.
Biega.
Real smart play.
Biega in his second NHL game. Just got off the ice. St. Louis moves in with a puck. Cuts in. Got a shot off. Saved by Miller. Good effort by Marty St. Louis.
Well, Vancouver had seven players on the ice. They know they had to make a change, and they all went back to make a change, and that left Marty St. Louis with room in front of their bench. There's St. Louis. There were two or three players for Vancouver that came off the bench or that headed to the bench, and then he ended up with that chance.
Just over 9 minutes to go here in the third period, now under nine. And the Rangers with a 4-3 lead, hustling to the puck. Derek Dorsett, John Moore on him. Stepniak was bumped by McMillan. Given away to Mathias, up the boards to Stanton. Back to Sean Mathias for the shot, wide. Yannick Weber playing it deep. Sean Mathias circling. And staying with him is Dan Boyle. Good play by Dan Boyle. He stayed with Mathias all the way. Weber fires across. McMillan dumps it into the Rangers zone. Boyle and Mathias after it again. John Moore able to move it, and it's cleared up the boards, but stopped and kept in. Dorsett, John Moore on him. Brassard has come on with Nash. Stempniak still on. The puck is out of the zone, and Stanton has it back. Just under 8 minutes to go in the third. Good play by Klein, stepping up. Brassard's pass intercepted. And Bo Horvat turning. Horvat with one of the goals for Vancouver. Stahl. Horvat trying to pick his pocket. Stahl moves it to Zuccarello and out of the zone. And Hughes. Broussard trying to take it away. Good job by Derek Broussard. Here comes Zuccarello. Canucks able to get clear. Hanson. Nice move on Stahl. Hanson pass. Save. Calvin got a piece of it sliding across. Horvat again.
I know, but
around the net.
He was getting pressure. I think Klein ended up making a pretty good defensive play on Horvat.
The back pass comes out of the zone. 7 minutes to go in the third.
Had Horvat not been bothered at all by Klein, he would have just tapped it in the empty side.
Up the boards for Higgins. Chris Higgins dumps it in and chases. Girardi. JT Miller tied up by Vey. Rabada's pass for Stanton. Rangers take it away. Hayes leads Haglund. Haglund races in. Haglund with a pass for JT Miller that was blocked by Viega. Play back to McDonough for a shot wide. Girardi comes down. Haglund behind the net. Haglund turns, fires around to Hayes. Kevin Hayes, checked by Lyndon Vey. Viega. Up for Verbata. And Vey circles as the Canucks change lines. Good play in the neutral zone by Derek Stepan. He stopped Daniel Sedin. That was tipped ahead but blocked by Kevin Klein. Rangers doing a good job of clogging up the neutral zone. And the fans with a Let's Go Rangers chant. Coming up, the Foxwoods Final Five. Foxwoods, excitement every day. Kreider coming back to break up that play. Glendening's got it with 5.5 minutes to go in the third. Spezza with a lead to Burrows. Burrows slowed down, taken away by Nash. Got it to Zuccarello, and now Broussard leads Nash. Nash races in, Ham Hughes comes over. Nash got it to Zuccarello, back for Broussard. Broussard comes out, open man McDonough. Glove saved by Miller. Oh, big shot, big save. 5:06 to go. Third period at the Garden. Rangers leading 4-3. The upcoming schedule brought to you by Lexus, the official luxury vehicle of the New York Rangers. Tomorrow night in Buffalo, that's the makeup game. It's on MSG2 at 7 p.m. Sunday night here at the Garden, 7:30 on MSG against the Columbus Blue Jackets. Tuesday night, Calgary Flames are here. That's on MSG Plus at 7 p.m. Hope you'll join us for all those games. Here's a look at that chance we talked about, Joe.
Yeah, see, Horvat just gets a piece, but he is being defended by Kevin Klein. Kevin Klein makes a good player. That's a little easy tap-in for Horvat.
Canucks control. Hanson with a touch pass to Kennens. Kennens sends it deep. Back forth, John Moore bumps with Hanson's or with Kennens in control. The pass out of the zone. And Hughes forced back by Zuccarello. The pass broken up by John Moore, sent in by Broussard. Rangers led 1-0 end of the first. Vancouver tied it at 1. Rangers took a 2-1 lead on a goal by Rick Nash. Vancouver tied it at 2. Vancouver took the lead 3-2 in the third, and the Rangers answering with two quick goals, span of 21 seconds, regained the lead. Mathias battling Hayes. Girardi is there. The puck behind the net comes to Yannick Hanson. Checked by McDonough. This is Glendening. His pass taken away by Hayes. Girardi backhands it ahead for Haglund. Comes to Mathias, who takes it back deep. Mathias forced behind the net by McDonough. The back pass. Glendening winds it around the boards. Talbot lost the stick momentarily. He's got it back. That pass coming all the way down will be an icing on the Rangers. 3:41 to go in the third. After the game, we've got complete post-game coverage coming your way. We'll hear from head coach Alain Vigneault. Mercedes-Benz Rangers postgame anchored by Al Trotwig with Brian Leach. We've got analysis from Joe Micheletti and from Dave Maloney. John Gianone working the locker room. We'll hear from the players on Mercedes-Benz Rangers postgame following the action. Rangers call a timeout. Rangers in Buffalo tomorrow night. And you wonder, will Cam Talbot play back-to-back games, or will 20-year-old Mackenzie Skatski make his NHL debut?
Yeah, hard to say.
The young man who was born in Vancouver the day after the Rangers won the Stanley Cup over the Canucks in 1994. Grew up a Vancouver Canucks fan. He's watching the team he grew up rooting for.
Yeah, I said the other day when I talked to him, he said he feels fine now. He said the first 4 or 5 days, he was a mess. It was a mess. Couldn't think out there on the ice. He said every time somebody would fake a shot, he would, you know, fall down. And, you know, he was just nervous. I mean, it's an exciting time, but it took him, you know, 4 or 5 days to start feeling comfortable with the shooters and what they were doing. He says he's comfortable now.
He's been practicing hard every day. Practiced this morning, worked on the ice with Marty St. Louis, with John Moore, with Matt Hunwick.
Of course, there's always Benoit Allaire to
along. Absolutely. He's the teacher, the master. Saved by Talbot on the shot by Henrik Sedin. Henrik trying to take it back from Girardi. In the corner, Daniel Sedin firing. Blocked by Girardi. Girardi chucks at the stick of Daniel Sedin. Rabada along the board. Burrows is there. The back pass to Spezza. Shot toward the net is blocked. Vancouver with four forwards on the ice, one defenseman. Bravada is back at the point in a defenseman's role. Henrik Sedin's pass deflects to the corner. Daniel is there. Now Henrik, checked by McDonough. Here's Daniel. Winds it around to Bravada, moved in deep. Past Burrows. Daniel Sedin to Henrik. Haglund tries to take it away. Girardi moves it around the glass. It's stopped and kept in by Spezza. He's the one defenseman on the ice for Vancouver. Pass through to Spezza. He shoots, deflected away. Up the board, Spezza's got it, 2:25 to go.
Rangers are tired, trying to defend this, stopping and starting. Can't get the puck out.
Spezza against Dominic Moore. To the bench goes Ryan Miller. They look to get an extra skater on. Rangers clear it out. 6 skaters on for Vancouver, the net is empty. Rangers have gotten the line change. Daniel Sedin's pass to Hamus. Moves in. Soft shot. He missed. Rebound score. Henrik Sedin has tied it with 2 minutes to go.
Henrik Sedin stayed on the ice while some of his teammates changed. That was a long shift for him. And what ends up turning out to be a key on this play, when Sedin gave the puck to Hamus, number two, he'll actually almost miss on this shot. Here it comes, watch, he almost fans on the shot, so it was weak. And that threw off Talbot, and he didn't have it. If it was harder, he would have been able to redirect it to the corner. But instead, it was a missed shot by Hamus. And Henrik Sedin jumps on the rebound and puts it in.
So the Canucks have tied the game for the third time. They've had the lead once. And under 2 minutes remaining in regulation time, it's 4-4. And Willie Desjardins, the head coach, made the move, putting on 4 forwards, 1 defenseman, kept the puck in the Rangers zone for a long time, and then got a 6th skater on, and Vancouver scored to tie with 2 minutes to go. Here's Horvat. Horvat backhands it deep. Minute 25 to go in regulation time. John Moore's got it. And you're watching the Foxwoods Final Five. Foxwoods, excitement every day. Visit foxwoods.com now. Off the corner boards, Matthias. Around to Dorsett, checked there by Stepan. Dorsett backhands it to the side of the net, puts it out in front, taken away. Out comes St. Louis with a lead to Kreider. Kreider against Biega. Kreider went high on Biega, with his arm and the helmet. Picked up by Stepan. Step on around the net. Turns, feeds Kreider, but it was broken up by Spezza. Kreider along the boards. Spezza behind the net. Step on, takes it away. Step on, off the back of the net. Spezza able to take it away. 35 seconds to go in regulation time. McDonough takes over. Both teams change. McDonough sends it in. It's blocked by Ham Hughes. And Ham Hughes up ahead for Alex Burrows. Girardi after the puck. Daniel Sedin on him. McDonough chips it off the boards, blocked by Burrows. Burrows keeps it alive. Girardi takes over with 10 seconds to go. He lifts it out of the zone. Broussard takes it off the boards. Winds it deep for Zuccarello. 2 seconds to go. We're going to overtime. Rangers have a point out of the game. The Canucks have come back throughout the game and tied it up. It's 4-4 heading for overtime, and a very valuable point at stake. We are back. Welcome to the New York Life Overtime Report. New York Life, keep good going. Henrik Sedin, 2 goals in the game. Well, he got the tying goal.
Yeah, here's all we got here, Sam. The Rangers had just a marvelous first period. And this is as good a passing play as you'll see. Girardi, St. Louis, Stepan, 1-0. And it was a period that was dominated by the Rangers. And then this one, Mathias comes off the bench. A little bit of a collision, knocked down the goaltender, Cam Talbot. And then this beautiful pass, Nash scores number 36 on the season. And then Horvat, 2-on-1, goes to the net, takes the pass from Kennens. And then on the power play, taking the lead was Vancouver, Henrik Sedin. And then here comes Marty St. Louis. Beautiful pass from Stepan. St. Louis does a rest. Marvelous goal. Ties it. And shortly after that, turnover. Henrik Sedin ends up throwing it to the middle of the ice. Dan Girardi will read it. Here it comes. Reads it. Looks up. Sees Hagelin breaking to the net. Puts it right on his stick for the deflection. Rangers had the lead. And then this one. Soft miss shot. Gets directed over to Henrik Sedin, who puts it in. Vancouver Canucks said no quit the way they played.
4-on-4, 5 minutes or less of sudden death, sudden victory overtime. Both teams have been good in the five-minute periods this season. Vancouver 5-2, the Rangers 4-1. Fans wanted a call when Zuccarello was taken down. Zuccarello is on with Broussard, McDonough, and Girardi. Henrik Sedin is on. Zuccarello trying to take it away. Hamhuis has it back.
Boy, it was at the end of the shift. He was just a little bit gassed.
Hamhuis brings it across. Daniel Sedin with Henrik Sedin. Spezza's on as well. Daniel's got it. Danger is here. Backhander kicked away by Talbot.
Hamhuis took Girardi out of the play, and that allowed Sedin to walk around.
Here's Daniel to Henrik. That was tipped. McDonough checking Henrik Sedin. Girardi takes it away from Daniel. Over a minute gone by in the overtime. Girardi to McDonough. Stepan and St. Louis have come on. Off the stick of Stepan, cleared out by Biega to Alex Burrows. Burrows with Verbata. Verbata shoots wide. Hard shot, goes all the way back into the Vancouver zone. Ryan Miller leaves it there for Alex Biega. Now Alex Burrows. Minute and a half gone by in the overtime. Burrows carrying. On him is Kevin Hayes. Dan Boyle is on, along with John Moore. Hayes and Nash. Hayes, pressured by Stanton. The pass given away to Mathias. And the setup to shot high by Burrows. Around the boards to Clendenning. I thought he pulled it out of the zone. He did. Offside. Minute 53 gone by in the overtime.
Yeah, again, we're going to show you a chance. Watch to the right in the middle of the screen. Hamhuis gets up and he takes Girardi out. Slows him, so that just allows Sedin to walk in and get the shot. And then this shot by Burrows was fluttering, and that went over the net.
Dominic Moore and Carl Hagelin on for the Rangers. Hagelin has a goal and an assist in the game. St. Louis a goal and an assist. Stepan a goal and an assist. Nash with a goal. Hagelin to Dominic Moore. Down the boards for Mark Stahl, who's in deep. The two defensemen are in deep. Hagelin shoots, saved by Miller. Both Ranger defensemen were deep in the offensive zone.
Well, they've been scoring just about every game. Might as well get another one in this one.
Here's Yannick Hansen. Stahl dives to block the shot.
Boy, that's a good defensive play. Hansen had speed.
There goes Hagelin. He ran into Glendening. As Glendening picked him off. 2:15 to go in the overtime. Tipped in by Dorsett. Back for it, John Moore. Dorsett takes it away. Centers. Nice play by Dan Boyle. Spisa for Dorsett. Taken by Boyle. Finds Zuccarello. Zuccarello tried to feed Brassard. It went by him. He didn't see it coming. A minute 55 to go in the overtime. Spisa moves in against John Moore. Round the net. Spisa maintains possession. Brassard got a piece of it. Higgins checked by Moore. Now played by Daniel Sedin just off the bench. Glendening to Daniel. And Daniel, excuse me, that's Henrik. And Henrik dropped it out of the zone. Now Daniel comes on to join Henrik. Here's Daniel Sedin. Minute 25 to go. Drop pass out of the zone. Picked up by St. Louis. Moving in with Brassard. Brassard looking for St. Louis. Just missed. He was looking for deflection in front. McDonough. Stick handles in. Checked by Henrik Sedin. Drops it off to St. Louis. St. Louis looking for Brassard. He shoots. And it deflects up into the netting and play stops with 1:03 to go in the overtime.
Now Daniel Sedin tried to make a drop pass just inside the Rangers blue line right here. The Rangers intercept. St. Louis, he's got Brassard with him. Little drop pass. Brassard tries to get it back and they just can't connect. And then one more chance and that one goes off the stick of Stanton, who is blocked. Quite a few quality chances by the Rangers tonight.
Stepan and Kreider on for the Rangers. Face-off win by Bo Horvat. Pressure by Kreider. Under a minute to go in the overtime period. Cam Hughes. Pressure by Stepan, who takes it away. Stepan controlling, feeds Kreider. Back to Stepan for the shot. Saved by Miller. He holds it. 43.2 remaining in the overtime. Our game recap brought to you by your Tri-Honda dealers. Derek Stepan, Marty St. Louis, Carl Hagelin, each with a goal and an assist. Rick Nash's 36th goal of the season. Henrik Sedin, 2 goals, 6 shots on goal. Henrik Sedin scoring with 2 minutes to go to match the goal scored by Carl Hagelin to tie the game at 4. McDonough moving with the puck. Toward the net is blocked in front by Weber. Picked up by Horvat. Horvat with Verbata. Stepan back for it. 30 seconds to go in the overtime. Kreider's got it. Kreider races up ice. To Boyle, trying to get it back. Verbata takes it. 20 seconds to go. Diving to get, chip it out of the zone was Ham Hughes. Verbata at the line, forced back. 10 seconds to go. Falling down Spisa, got it to Weber. Weber for Daniel Sedin. Boyle ties up Weber. And this game will go to a shootout. Not enough time as Nash and Stepan were racing down the ice. 65 minutes played, no decision yet. Rangers and Canucks to a shootout when we come back. We are set for the shootout brought to you by New York Life. There's Ryan Miller. Cam Talbot 0-1 in his career in shootout, or 0-1 this season in shootout. Derek Stepan this season, 2-for-3. Zuccarello 2-for-5, and it looks like Zuccarello's going to start it off as Alain Vigneault checks things out with Scott Arneil. Rangers shoot first. Matt Zuccarello will start it off. Looking for a big extra point in the standings. And the crowd on its feet at the Garden. Zuccarello moves in on Ryan Miller, slows down. Shoots, saved by Miller.
Well, Ryan Miller just outweighed him. Zuccarello kept waiting for Ryan Miller to maybe make a move so he could find something, and Miller was, you know, he went down with the left leg once, got right back up in a hurry, and was in position to make the save.
Alex Burrows for Vancouver. You see the numbers. Alex Burrows goes wide, moves in on Cam Talbot, and scores!
He nice. Threw him off a little bit, Sam, with that move. He did the old circle right around the puck. Watch him go right around the puck. And then the quick shot. I think he probably just threw him off a little bit, that little move. You don't see that very often. It was a good move.
Derek Stepan. See the career numbers. 2 for 3 this season. And he starts in slowly. Stepan cuts in, shoots, save Miller. And now Vancouver can win it. Radim Vrbata coming up.
He tries to go high on the short side. And Miller was there, got the blocker up. And Radim Vrbata.
He's had good numbers in his career in shootouts. Vrbata moves in with speed, slows down, and scores! And it's over. The Vancouver Canucks have come back and defeated the Rangers in a shootout, 5-4. The Rangers get a point out of the game, but they let the lead slip away 3 times, and Vancouver wins in the shootout.
Now, beautiful move by Vrbata on the backhand and then up high, just underneath the crossbar. There it is again. Verbata's had a wonderful season. Their leading goal scorer after coming over as a free agent. And Talbot's reaction, shake of the head, frustration. This was a gutsy performance by Vancouver. A depleted lineup. 6 regulars out of the lineup for Vancouver, 4 on defense. And this looked like it was going to be one-sided in the first period. They came back strong.
Canucks were down. Rangers had chances to put it away, couldn't do it. Vancouver wins in a shootout. We'll be right back.